Now another pair of concepts, abstraction and refinement. All design methods support these ideas. After all, we're dealing with large systems, and the only way that we can wrap our mind around those large systems is to think about them in terms of abstract concepts, and then how we're going to refine each of those abstract concepts into lower-level implementations. Programming languages, design techniques, typically provide some conceptual mechanisms for dealing with abstraction. Here are a few. For example, the whole process of specification, where we're dealing with the what, abstracts away all the details of how we're going to solve the problem. Programming languages typically have various aggregation abstractions, such as arrays and structs and records and objects, that allow you to, if you wish, avoid the details of what all the features of those aggregations are. Obviously, in object-oriented languages, the whole idea of the class hierarchy and generalization allows you to abstract away from all the special cases. Even a fundamental thing like the parameters to procedure calls or function calls allow you to abstract away from what all the various possible calls to those functions are by specifying names for the parameters rather than all of the specific arguments. And finally, non-determinism, at least at the specification level, where you can avoid giving details of exactly how you're going to implement something by specifying that you, in certain circumstances, you don't care.